occupy less than 1% of the bottoms of the ocean, but they provide home for 25% of all marine species. Roughly one quarter of the coral reefs around the world are already considered damaged beyond repair, with another two-thirds under serious threat.
Did you know? The diversity of life found on the coral reefs rivals that of the tropical forest of the Amazon and New Guinea. Some estimates put the total amount of species at nearly 2 million.
And did you know that coral reefs can only survive in waters from 22 to 28 degrees Celsius? Anything below or above that will kill the corals. Coral reefs can only be found in clean, warm waters of the Caribbean, around the Indo-Pacific Islands, as well as north of Australia. So these are dead corals. They look like some kind of stone or plant to me, but they're not. So what are corals?
Well, somebody that can tell us all about corals and the coral reef is Bob Stanek. You know, he's been studying our corals for quite a long time now, and he might have some valuable information for us.
Hi.
Hey.
So nice
hey,
to
how
meet
are you?
Hi, I'm Julia. Nice
Hi,
to meet
Julia.
You.
Both of these are actually related. They are a type of animal that looks like a little flower. They're tiny and they can capture food that way, and they form a colony. What you're seeing here are the grooves where the animal that has its little hands coming out here grabbing plankton, and they get sunlight, so they actually work a little bit like a plant. And so we call this a symbiosis. And what they do is they produce the habitat by taking limestone out of the seawater and forming these structures, which we call coral, and a bunch of coral forms a coral reef.
So why are corals so important?
Well, it's a habitat for many animals, and many people call it an undersea rainforest because it has so many different species. The other thing about coral reefs is that in many places they're natural breakwaters. The sea comes in and the first thing the sea hits are the coral reefs. And a lot of people depend on the fish that live in and around coral reefs. In some places, 80% of the protein that some communities get come from the fish that live on a coral reef.
80%, that's a lot.
It's very high.
Yeah.
That's right. So if anything happens to coral reef, it's a lot of problems.
So what kinds of animals live in the coral reefs? Is it only fish or?
Boy, you know, inside the reef, you always see the outer surface of the reef. But the reef is a three-dimensional structure, and there are animals that never see the light of day that live inside the reef. But it's measured in the thousands.
Wow.
Yeah.
We've learned that coral reefs have existed for millions of years. So why then are the coral reefs decaying these last 20 or 40 years if they've been stable all that time?
What we are seeing is a lot of problems related to coral reefs that relate to climate change. We have, when corals get too hot, they take the plants that are in their bodies and they expel them. They bleach out white. And that's almost like if you were to bleed yourself. If it's a couple of weeks of completely bleached state, the coral will die. I think that we're dealing with a complex system where we have these ecosystems that are suffering from climate change, atmospheric change. Carbon dioxide in the atmosphere creates carbonic acid, so the oceans are turning acidic, and overfishing.
So, are there any good signs or positive signs of, improvement in the coral reefs?
Yeah, there are. And one of the things that's very interesting, and the reason why I started working in Bonaire, is that Bonaire has always been one of the bright spots, one of the very best coral reefs in the Caribbean. And so some of the things that happened in Bonaire, in 1971, they banned the use of spear guns. That was great. There's no big tradition of using fish traps, but they have since phased out fish traps. Parrotfish that keep the reef clean of seaweed have been banned in terms of the harvest of parrotfish. The number of reefs in the Caribbean that have shown recovery after disaster are very few, but Bonaire looks to be one of them.
So, do you have any advice for us as junior rangers and the other young generation as to how we can, you know, take on this coral situation that to help it improve in the future?
Yep. There are short-term and long-term things you can do, but I think in the long term, one of the things that I would love you to think about and see if you feel comfortable with, but just don't eat reef fish.
Okay.
Coral reef fish grow very slowly. They're not sustainable. The fish that you can eat sustainably include mahi-mahi, wahoo, mackerel. Those are fine alternatives, but right now you can walk down the street and have barracuda. And barracuda is a reef fish. So if you care about these coral reefs, and they're very small, actually, on the whole scheme of things, just don't eat reef fish.
If you want to conserve our reefs, don't eat reef fish, but eat lionfish.